Hi, good morning. This is the second part of my podcast from last week. If you listen to my podcast, you will know that Jay, who is someone God sent me for, yet he has engaged a pagan woman and married to her in a pagan marriage ceremony, who in turn afflicted him with mental health problems. Jay, who is not in Christ, taken in by the pagans throughout his life, and his last deception against myself and making second set of falsified allegations on the day I went to give Bible to him is an evidence against himself. The Lord, who is fair and just, will not receive Jay till he makes the decision to follow Lord Jesus Christ, and only then Jay will have courage to stand up like a man. For the Lord revealed to me on the 13th of June 2019, Jay is not able to stand up to people. And following year, on the 16th of June 2020, the harlot who had mental health problems, who looked like a young man, jumped on Jay. She was all over him, like a rash in her sickness. And the following year, on the 13th of June 2021, God has shown me the harlot who is evil-spirited, lives in the pit with the Satan. Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 11, titled Be Holy. O Corinthians, we have spoken openly to you. Our heart is wide open. You are not restricted by us, but you are restricted by your own affections. Now in return for the same, you also be open. Do not be unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness? And what communion has light with darkness? And what accord has Christ with Belial? Or what part has a believer with an unbeliever? And what agreement has the temple of God with idols? For you are the temple of the living God. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk among them. I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Therefore come out from among them, and be separate, says the Lord. Do not touch what is unclean, and I will receive you. I will be a father to you, and you shall be my sons and daughters, says the Lord Almighty. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Amen to that. Although Jay, who is ceremonially married to this pagan woman, who lives in the pit with the evil one, told me in spirit that he will come for me between 2 to 4 years. This means from the moment God put us together in December 2016 to the time he accepts the Lord and his pleasing goodwill upon his life and invites Lord Jesus Christ into his heart and makes a conscious decision to follow the Lord is somewhere between 6 to 7 years. And in that moment, when he makes the decision to follow Lord Jesus Christ, at that moment, Lord will receive him, not before. Till then, he remains under the wrath of God. For the word of God says, because of these things, the wrath of God comes upon the sons of disobedience. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 6. I pray for all our loved ones who are imprisoned by the Satan, for them to turn to Lord Jesus Christ and receive him into their hearts forever and ever. Amen. As Lord Jesus Christ said, most assuredly I say to you, he who receives whomever I send receives me, and he who receives me receives him who sent me. When Jesus had said these things, he was troubled in spirit and testified and said, most assuredly I say to you, one of you will betray me. John chapter 13, verses 20 and 21. Hence, as you know, Jay by his actions became the betrayer of the Bible. He conspired with the police and invited me to the park to talk, yet arranged them to come and arrest me on the day I went to give Bible to him, as Lord will. Next, I got arrested in the middle of the park in West London. As Lord Jesus Christ said, I was daily with you in the temple, teaching, and you took me not, but the scriptures must be fulfilled. Mark chapter 14, verse 49. All my laptops and court documents where I was seeking justice have been taken away by the police, who's supposedly investigating this stalking offense of taking Bible to Jay, who conspired with the police and invited me to the park to talk, yet secretly arranged for them to come and arrest me, hence became the betrayer of the Bible. Jay, by doing what he did, conspired with the police to get me arrested, is not any different than what Judas did to Lord Jesus Christ and became the betrayer of the world. And interestingly, I was in custody for 30 hours while 30 pieces of silver were paid for Lord Jesus Christ's arrest in conspiracy. The situation may look bleak for Jay, who became the betrayer of the Bible and betrayed the holy servant of God, hence the Lord. Yet Lord made me hear in spirit that Jay will come for me between 2 to 4 years. That may look like a long time, considering it has been 4.5 years since God put us together. As we know, God is not in hurry, for he has a purpose and he works in all of us. As Bible says, the Lord is not slow in keeping his promise, as some understand slowness. Instead, he is patient with you, not wanting anyone to perish, but everyone to come to repentance. In 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 9, the promise of God is to whoever receives Lord Jesus Christ into their hearts. Wherever you are, whatever you are doing today, receive the Lord and invite him into your hearts and receive the Lord and his Holy Spirit upon your lives. When the time is fulfilled and when his purpose is accomplished upon our lives, he will make the way for Jay and for all who are imprisoned by the Satan and will bring them in repentance before him. And in that moment, when he turns to the Lord and invites him into his heart, he will be set free from the imprisonment he is in by the Satan and his advocates in his life. In fact, God made me hear and see. At the beginning, Jay was practically begging me to be with me, and I have seen him in front of me on his both knees. As I said in last week's podcast, the truth will set him free whenever he accepts Lord Jesus Christ as his righteous Savior and receives him into his heart. In terms of our healing that is in Lord Jesus Christ, I would like to read these beautiful Bible verses from Malachi chapter 4 from verses 1 to 3. It's titled The Great Day of God. For behold, the day is coming, burning like an oven, and all the proud, yes, all who do wickedly will be stumbled, and the day which is coming shall burn them up, says the Lord of hosts, that will leave them neither root nor branch. But to you who fear my name, the Son of Righteousness shall arise with healing in his wings, and you shall go out and grow fat like stall-fed calves. You shall trample the wicked, for they shall be ashes under the soles of your feet, on the day that I do this, says the Lord of hosts. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Amen to that. Whomever hears this message today, turn to the Lord and live in him for the glory of God the Father and the Son, and receive your healing from Lord Jesus Christ, and the Lord shall receive you. Amen to that. May God bless you all in Christ Jesus. Amen.